fit. Look at this lot. Kayla's gonna take one look at him and die laughing.
How much longer must we wait? Crowds are fickle things. I know too well what can happen when moods turn sour.
Viconia? Is that you?
What's this now? Our drow knows the hero of Baldur's Gate?
Not very well, only in passing, I'm afraid. Your drow, she says, I belong to no man, Fog, and certainly not you. Well met, Sapphire. It's been a while. I did not search for her. What are you doing here?
We're all here for the same reason. The Council put the word out looking for those ready to fight against this Kaelor, and we are always ready for a fight.
The Dukes must be more desperate than I thought.
You like the taste of teeth, do ye? You're this close to eating yours. Get out of my face now before yours gets broke.
Me and my friends will kill you. You realize that, don't you? I'm sure we'll talk again, Sapphire. Vedoust. Okay, is that a word in drow? Drowian? Yeah, we'll talk now.
What is it you want now?
I thought we might talk.
We have nothing to talk about.
She looks like she might be some kind of cleric? Or perhaps paladin, anti-paladin, whatever? We do have something to talk about. I would have you by my side.
Me join you? That would drive Faerûn mad. And drive him mad I shall. Are we off?
Dine here doesn't like that. Viconia has joined my party. Among those in Foghammerless company was a drow cleric of Shar, Viconia de Vere. I hadn't expected to see her again, but quickly secured her aid. If I dismiss Viconia, she will travel with Fog with the Flaming Fist caravan. I can find her at the Flaming Fist camp. Okay, and I thought I heard that sound. Fog says, keep gawking, wide-eyed stooges such as are. Dinahair says, thy fear is too far from the path of light. Correct thine steps. So, she's either referring to her reputation being decreased by two, or the addition to Viconia in our party, or both. But we have a cleric. So I'm hoping Dinah here does not leave us, because that would also mean Minsk leaves us, but we need a cleric.
Yes, Abel.
Take a look. Abel? She's neutral evil. So right now she's level 7. She has some kind of magic resistance, maybe innate, I'm not sure. Fighting styles, warhammer, mace, and sling. And she's got bonus priest spells. ...65 magic resistance. Open doors 10. When asked about her past, Viconia snaps that there is nothing about her you need to know. Over her time, you've learned that... Over time? Well, it's only been like a minute. You've learned that Viconia is a drow from the city of Menzoberranzan, though she left her home some time ago for unspecified reasons. Life on the surface has been hard for Viconia. She turned away from the traditional drow worship of Loth and instead venerates Shara, goddess of darkness and loss. Viconia still finds the customs and mannerisms of surface dwellers strange and takes malicious amusement in watching others struggle to decide how best to deal with her. Traveling with you has afforded Viconia some measure of protection, and she seems content, for the time being, to remain in your company during the march to Dragonspear Castle. And loud music happens. Let's level up. Hold on. What is she using? She's using a mace plus one. So we should give her proficiency in mace. Oh, we can't. Not yet, anyway. Additional weapon. Okay, flail and morning star, I suppose. Alright, so she's level 8 now. I didn't look to see what else went up, but... well, kind of surprise. So, she knows... right now, she has two command, Cure Light Wounds, Remove Fear, and Sanctuary. Command. I realize we have to sleep again to have this stuff put in, but, Bless, and probably another Cure Light Wounds. Yes. Okay. Here she knows Chant. Chant is good. Hold Person. Slow Poison. These are good. I'll probably leave them here, but... resist fire and cold. And silence. Okay. Here she has one empty, actually. Cure disease. Is that new? Remember ever using Cure Disease. Blindness, Deafness, and Feeble-Minded also cure with the spell. Cure Medium. Remove Paralysis. I'll keep this just in case we have a lot of diseases now. And here we have Defensive Harmony. Grants affected creatures a defensive bonus by bestowing an enchanted coordination on their attacks and defenses. This allows a group of creatures to act as a single unit for a single battle or encounter. The effect is always centered on the caster, but affects all allies within a 15-foot radius. Okay, so TLDR plus 2 bonus AC, okay. Mental Domination. Cure Serious Wounds, not even memorized. Free Action, Farsight. Animal Summoning. Four hit dice or less, two or three animals. It could be useful. Not extremely, though. Neutralize poison. We do have a lot of poison flasks. She actually has poison itself. Protection from evil. 10-foot radius. How would that work? Because she's evil, but she can protect against evil? Okay, she's no 5 yet. Okay. Now. Okay. Okay, she has bullet plus 1, bullet of electricity plus 1, bullet plus 2. She comes with 5 potions of healing, 5 antidotes, and 3 elixirs of health. And a small shield plus 1, silver circlet, which gives her saving throws plus 1. A circlet is a circular band typically made of precious metal worn on the head as an ornament or symbol of status. This silver circlet is enchanted to bring the wearer luck in battle, slightly improving the chance of successful saving throws. And then splint mail plus 1. Can't do it. Alright. So, maybe see if we can find her some better armor? At least? Armor class 3. Her AC is negative 3. She has 43 hit points.
What?
Who has the best... I mean, it was Imowen we were using to buy things with. I have charisma 15, 9, 14, 70, actually, Safana.
I'm the best woman for the job.
No, you are not, but you have the best charisma, so go
Such
buy something.
Menial tasks.
You want me? Right.
Your actions are as ill-judged as they are incomprehensible.
My name marches on its stomach.
Remember saying that? Alright, 5601. Plate mail. Oh my god. Plate mail plus 1. We can barely afford that. Look at that. 5601. 5600. I mean, we are going to sell her other plate mail back. I mean, her splint mail. So this is armor class 2. Does she have 12 strength? That's my question, actually. Armor class 1, but we can afford. Let me make sure we don't actually have something first. Probably sold it all. Wait a second. We have on-cake plate mail. Okay. That would have been a mistake to give her that. We have on-cake plate mail. What is her strength at? 10. Okay. So just out of curiosity...
Sweetheart? Right.
I have many fine wares.
I think she might not have been able to wear that anyway. Requires 12 strength.
I am yours to command.
She has 10, yeah. That would have been no good. So the oncake plate mail is actually perfect for her. It's lighter. Here. AC minus 5. Split mail. There's no one else here who can wear split mail. I think we'll sell this to him.
Hmm, Whatever.
Army
you like.
Marches on its stomach.
It's only 600. Alright. So what it... Someone said something. Oh, Viconia says, your actions are as ill-judged as they are incomprehensible. I meant to check this. Our reputation's still popular, so I would think because it's Viconia in the party, yeah, this could be a problem. Might have been because I made her leader. Alright. So I don't think there's anyone else here to talk to. I think we talked to everybody.
Magic is impressive, but now Minsk leads. Swords for everyone!
Alright, let's be on our way then.
There you are. The caravan's at the palace gate. We're ready to head to Dragonspear if you are.
Ready. Let's go. Quite a cheer. Show Kayla what we do with our kind in the gate. Nobleman says, what are you doing? Cheering? Cheering for a sibling of Saravok? That's what they are. They found Saravok's journal. It reveals the truth. But the Council of Four wants to keep it a secret. Commodore says, is that true, Sapphire? Are you a child of Baal? Corwin says, you question the hero of Baldur's Gate? I can handle this, Captain Corwin. That's a bad idea. Alright, I'm not going to tell them I'm Ballspawn. I'm curious to see what it says, though. Well, yeah, I definitely wouldn't say that. Hear me, people of Baldur's Gate. I know you suffered at Saravok's hands. I know you fear what the future holds. With the heretic Kalar driving good people from their homes across the Sword Coast, I hear your cries for justice, and I swear to you, I shall end this threat to us all. Well done, Corwin says. Let's be on our way before some other wind turns the crowd against us. Give him hell, Sapphire!
Captain Shale Corwin and her aide, Corporal Bence Duncan, maintain order in the caravan from Baldur's Gate. Some who joined the expedition are unaccustomed to flaming fist discipline. Hard lessons are learned in the early days of the march north. The journey is slowed by the Crusade's victims. A multitude of broken, haunted men and women clog the coast way. When asked, they speak of fields set aflame, granaries ransacked, and family conscripted by the Crusade. Yet many characterize these hardships as necessary sacrifices in pursuit of a greater good. A strange acceptance, even admiration of Kalar Argent is disconcertingly common in those she has wronged. Some proclaim the Shining Lady a prophet, doing the work of not one but all faiths, all gods. Is it possible Kalar Argent's cause is a righteous one? Or is she engaged in a great deception to further her own agenda, as Saravok once did?
I don't know, but let's find out.
And what of your goals?
Many souls were lost during the Dragonspear Wars. I will see justice done and restore them to the light.
Yes, quite honorable. But what makes you think yourself capable of achieving this, Kayla Argent?
You dare befoul my person with your magics?
Blood is something to behold,
did it
not
again.
Fear. Your divine heritage radiates from you. From which of your parents, mother or father?
Enough of these games and enough of your questions. Heffernan, get this mage out of my sight.
At once, my lady. We will have words about this, scarred one.
Perhaps.
That guy had wings.
It has been too long since Minsk journeyed with such a fine companion.
So, the hooded man... Oh, I got a lot of XP. Journal updated. Oh, we're into another chapter now. Either I didn't notice this, that her first name is Shale, or I forgot. So it is a new chapter now. That's good. I can't find this journal entry, though. Oh. Oh, I can add things. I don't know if it stays though. Okay. Out of the way there, you're blocking progress. We have someone by the name of Glint. Here's Raphus again. Belagarm. Flaming Fists. Members. Thaird. Looks like a dwarf, I guess. I thought at first hobgoblin. Petrescus. And Fog once again. Mizena. Okay.
Huh?
I deserve to be leader.
Indeed. Let's talk to Glint.
Let's talk more fight!
What is it?
I'm talking to Glint.
Trouble?
Yes.
What? Fine.
What? What? Oh, hello. Excuse me. I've got to go.
Go where exactly? Who are you?
My name. Oh, right, my name. I'm Glint. Glint, Three Eyes Gardener Simpson. Pleased to meet you.
Gardener Simpson. Three Eyes?
Ah, yes. Yes, an old nickname. That's how many eyes Mom said she had to keep on me to make sure I stayed out of trouble. Turns out she really needed four eyes, but that's a long story.
You gonna join us? Well, we do have room for another. He's a gnome something. I suppose we'll check him out. A story I'd be most interested in hearing if you're willing to share it. Would you consider joining me for a time?
All right. Yes. Join you. I can do that.
Oh, he's got 15 gold. Breaking the bank here. Alright, it comes with bullets. A morning star plus... Who is he? Oh, he's a cleric slash thief. Okay. He's got potions of extra healing, elixir of health, invisibility. Belt of the Cunning Rogue. Leather armor plus two and a buckler plus one. This belt, though. This wide leather belt has been dyed a deep magenta. The belt was created over a decade ago by a human thief who saw his larcenous activities as a means of worshipping Mask. All his burglaries were undertaken with prayers to Mask, and he hoarded his stolen goods at a hidden altar to the god of thieves. He favored purple clothing, believing it was a color the god preferred, and he crafted this belt to match his ensemble. The thief was eventually caught and killed on one of his missions, and the belt confiscated by the city guard. The next night, the belt vanished from a locked chest in the guardhouse, though whisked away by Mask so that it could continue to serve the god's ends. Even today, the belt often finds its way into the path of those who will put it to good use. The pouches attached to the belt contain a number of small tools, wires, picks, and blades that can be used to pick locks, and disable traps. Okay, so it's open locks and find traps plus 15%. That's interesting. Armor class 1, 53 hit points. I'm not completely sure if we're going to keep him cleric slash thief. I mean, we have a cleric and we have a thief, but if problems break out between Viconia and Dinah here, we might have to get rid of her, because I'm not losing Dinah here and Minsk. That can't happen. Alright, so anyway, he's level 6. Open locks 105, find traps 100. The others are less. When asked about his past, Glint Gardner-Sunson tends to use three words where one will do and constantly breaks off on tangents as he speaks. Eventually, you learn that he comes from a large family and has always been seen as something of a troublemaker. He gained his nickname Three Eyes when his exasperated mother claimed that she needed three eyes to keep watch on him. Glint happily expounds on his many adventures since leaving home. It's difficult to tell where reality ends and exaggeration begins. Though Glint initially ventured from Baldur's Gate in search of several missing relatives, he seems to have been caught up in the mission of ending Kalar's crusade. Oh, I can't talk to him now that he's in the group, right? That's a bad thing. Oh, and Glint levels up now. Okay, so... Save versus paralysis... Poison death, yeah, saves are reduced by either 1 or 2, as you see here. Thaco reduced by 2. Level 4 spells. 50 more skill points. 10 more hit points. Lore increased by 6, so... he's... Because of the belt, we don't need to put anything in open locks or find traps, really, because I think it's giving us, yeah, plus 15. So that's 105, and that's 100. Hiding in shadows really needs help. Detect illusions, set traps, I don't really care about. We have healing, so that's a good thing. We have the 10-foot spell. Sanctuary. And then... Sanctuary. Let's get rid of that. I mean, it is helpful, but... Wait a second. We don't know any poison type spells? Like cure poison, or is that second level? That's second. Hmm. I'm putting it back in. He's unmemorized now. I mean, he doesn't... When we rest, he'll know it again. Chant. Hold person. We really like to know these hold persons, don't we? Slow poison. What about... He doesn't know bless, does he? Hmm. Yeah, let's get rid of Sanctuary, put Bless, actually. And then our final spell for here. Hmm. Another slow poison, I guess. Remove Paralysis, Holy Smite. I mean, because we know we have Cure Medium here. Alright. That's better. I'm actually going to call in an episode here before we start talking to all these people. Wow. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.
A pleasant enough walk, though I feel solitary so far from civilization's walls.